back to game. Right then, my double. Excuse me, sir, that's not on, thank you.
You disappeared anyway, Cecil.
There's a lobby, let's get inside it. What's this then, my son?
Oh, excuse me. This is a laboratory. It's another thing on the Hive server, actually. It's three random mini games. And I might win, I might not, Cecil. I'd just like you to watch me and congratulate me on my achievements therein.
What if you achieve nothing, Paul? Like, you know, the rest of your life?
Well, then you can get to piss, Cecil. I'm going to drink some Fun Factory Cola. And that's fizzy. And here we go with the three games. What have we got? We've got Whack-a-Mob. Catastrophic. And then the third one, we've got Breaking Blocks. Don't know what that is. I don't know what that is. Oh.
So how are you doing, my boy?
Oh, I'm doing very well, Cecil. It's a bank holiday. It's a bank holiday weekend. I've had a lovely time. I've just sat on my bum. And I've done nothing for three whole English days long.
What are you doing then?
In the game, I've got to shoot enemies and get lots of points. All the points in the world. Further away than an enemy is, the more points you get. And then I get the top of the leaderboard because I'm amazing. You just keep watching that on the right hand side, Cecil. It'll say Radio Thanks in no time at all, I guarantee it. And you can take my guarantees to the bank. You see there, I'm at the bottom now.
Right, so you've just sat on your ass and done nothing for 3 days.
I have, Cecil, that's right. It's like being a child over the summer holidays.
Now, when I was a child on the school summer holidays, I'd got a job, Paul. What did you do with the school summer holidays?
Put on about 10 stone. It was wonderful. Best time of my life. Amazing time to be alive, Cecil. Absolutely amazing time. Remember in 1997, when I was 17, and I just stayed in my bedroom for 4 weeks, practically. New mum brought me my meals. I went to the toilet, obviously. Came out when I was 15 stone heavier. Oh, it was amazing. Mum had to knit me, sew me special clothes together, although I didn't. I just sat in my pants. Oh, I loved it. Absolutely loved it.
You're not doing very well, Paul.
I know, it's a bit piss poor, isn't it? Oh, 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 Skellington, Bon Bellington, Linda Bellingham's a Skellington.
Paul, that's not very nice.
Shit. Come third from bottom. That's rubbish, I was at the top, and I've crashed hard.
Yes.
What's this? Avoid the TNT and creepers. Test objectives, right, so just run around and not get hit. Michael Jackson. So, Cecil, that we've established what I've done with my weekend. Absolutely nothing. What's old biddy boy done with his old biddy weekend?
Well, I did a very, very terrible social faux pas the other day.
A faux pas?
Yes.
Oh, what was your faux pas, Cecil? Tell me all about it, old biddy tits.
Paul, please. Oh, steady. Well, excuse me. I'm just going to hide here, no one will get me. I don't know how to tell you this, Paul, but I've got a lady friend at the moment I've been seeing on and off for a short while. I don't know where it's going yet. It might be going nowhere.
Right. What?
Yes.
Right.
Yes. And I thought, right, oh, hello. I thought, I'm gonna be romantic, Paul.
Oh, you're not going to cook for her. I'm not getting out of the kitchen if I'm in there eating my crisps.
No, when Cecil does romance, Cecil goes big.
Does Cecil speak refer to himself in the third person, does he? Is Cecil a pretentious bastard?
Yes, Cecil is.
Alright, okay, fair enough.
So Cecil thought, oh, well, tell you what, love, we'll go on holiday together. So I'm taking her away on holiday part in September.
Oh, what? Where to?
I'm not telling you.
Man. Oh. Destroy as much of the environment as you can in the given time. Collect TNT from the gold blocks. Right.
So, Cecil. Oh, sorry. I went into town because she gets frightfully travel sick.
Right.
And, oh, hello. And I thought, right, I'll go into Boots Pharmacy, and I'll get her some travel sickness tablets. So I was stood in the queue at the pharmacy. It was quite a long queue, and I was still listening to the pharmacist. And, well, let's say he was definitely fruity.
What do you mean, Cecil?
He had a very camp voice, Paul, very camp indeed. I would bet my left testicle that he was a homosexual gentleman. Not that there's anything wrong with that, of course. But he was, and, I didn't need to acknowledge that. It would be embarrassing for him. But I was stood in the queue and he was talking to a lady. She was excuse me, sir. She was asking a lot of questions about Imodium.
What?
Well, she wasn't sure whether she was constipated or whether she had the runs, because the gentleman was too polite to ask her directly whether she was pooing all the time or not pooing at all.
Right, Aston.
She just kept saying, I need some pills for my bottom, it's gone funny. There's poo issues.
Right, Aston, that's not very good, is it? That's not very helpful.
No. Oh.
We finished three games, so that was terribly short. Very poor. Very poor. Very poor.
So I was stood behind her, listening to the very camp gentleman saying, oh yes, ducky.
Was he really saying ducky? Did he even say ducky once, Cecil?
No, he didn't. Anyway, it came to Cecil's turn to talk to him. And, I did a bit of a faux pas, Paul.
What did you say? Did you say something unpleasant to him?
Well, I had a card in my hand to give him to get the, travel sickness tablets. But instead of saying, thank you, sir, can I have these? I said, these are for my girlfriend! In a sort of panicked, rushed tone, as if to say, I'm not homosexual, I don't want bumming, thank you very much. And he looked to me a little shirty, and there was some very cold tension in the air, and he gave me some quells, and I made my excuses and left. It was a bit awkward, Paul, for me.
Right, I see. It's not very nice, is it?
No, it was a bit embarrassing. Ow! Just kicked the table.
Gold Rush, don't know what that is. Breaking Blocks, have just done that one. Balloon Pop, don't know what that one is either.
Right, probably popping balloons, wouldn't you say?
I probably would, Cecil. So what I'd like to know now, Cecil, is... Let's have some sound on this son of a bitch. Oh, that's too loud to me now. What do we do? I didn't read it. I don't know what to do, Cecil. I don't know what to do. I didn't read it. What happens?
It's called gold rush. Just mine gold. As much gold as you can manage, Paul.
That I will do. I will do, Cecil. So when are we going on holiday then? Pies and I. Cecil, when are we going on holiday?
What? Do you want some crisps, Paul?
No, I want to know when we're going on holiday, Cecil.
I'm going on holiday in September.
All right, where are we going? Cecil. Where are we going on holiday, Cecil?
I never said you were going, Paul. I said me and my girlfriend were going. My lady friend, she's... She's an elderly woman and she doesn't want to be around the likes of you. You'd be a gigantic third wheel.
What?
You'd be a gigantic third wheel, Paul, and there's nothing worse than being on a biddy bus with a gigantic third wheel. So I've already got many, many wheels, Paul. Thank you very much.
You're saying gigantic for?
Because that's how you correctly pronounce it.
Tell you what I haven't seen for a long time, Cecil. Jeremy Cream. Is it him you're going on holiday with? Have you gone homosexual?
No, I haven't. Don't be silly. It's a lady. A lady friend.
Right.
You did piss Paul there, Paul.
Set off. Why aren't I going, Cecil? I want to go on holiday. Just try as much tin as possible.
You're not coming, Paul. You're not welcome, thank you.
I was the person got first place already.
Because, hey. Hey, now.
I wanna go on holiday, Cecil.
Well, you're not invited, Paul. You're not welcome. You're not wanted. Okay?
That's not nice.
I don't care if it's nice or not, Paul. I have to put myself before you sometimes. Oh, it's very loud.
Where are you going? Come here. I've got money. Just I've got... Ow! I've got money. There's a place going to come in there. Cecil. Please, Cecil. Cecil, please, I'd like it.
No, Paul, you've said it once, I've said it a dozen times. You're a gigantic third wheel.
I'm going to find this woman and somehow disrupt your relationship so that you've got a spare ticket by the time it comes to go and you have to take me. Oh, I've got tint. Got more tint. Come on, chubby Parthax. Everyone's rooting for you. Everyone wants you to do well. Everyone likes you.
But that's not true.
You shut up. Oh, bastard. I might get away with some of my friends then.
Who are you going away with, Paul? Nobody's your chum.
Shut up.
No.
Pop the balloons. Oh, you bastard. Oh, you bastard. Oh, you bastard. Oh, bastard.
It was not speaking to me now, was that it?
Oh, you bastard.
Oh, grow up.
Oh, you bastard. Gonna make your life a living hell from now until you go, Cecil. You'll see. Oh, you'll see. Yeah, right. Oh, busy tits. Gonna get you up at 8 in the morning.
That's alright, Paul. I get up at 6 anyway. Stupid boy. You don't get up before no one.
Excellent, huh? Is it excellent? Excellent, excellent. They're not popping to me, Cecil.
Good. You don't deserve it. I've become last. In life.
I'm pissed off. You're a terrible parent. Just want to go on holiday, Cecil.
Tough to Tingtons.
Right, fine, I'll ask Mum if she wants to go on holiday with me then.
You do that, Paul. You ask your mother to see what happens.
This is rubbish.
You're a gigantic idiot, Cecil.
Ah, stud off!